Hello, YouTube gamers. Serica LaRue here, and today I want to talk about something I've been playing around with, perhaps way too much, and that is Gallows Fusion in Persona 5. Specifically, this is going to be a quick guide on when to use Gallows Fusion and how to make the most of it. Skill inheritance is perhaps one of the most interesting parts of Persona. For many hardcore Persona fans, it's not just about unlocking your favorite Persona, but also getting the abilities you want on said Persona. After all, many players like myself don't necessarily play with the most powerful Personas, but rather the Personas that they like the most. And what's wonderful about Persona games is that they often have several methods of creating a custom-tailored Persona of your choice, since nearly every ability is inheritable. There are exceptions, of course. Some Persona can never acquire certain abilities. For instance, I haven't found a way to put Gigantomachia on Alice, who's my all-time favorite. And of course, Alice's signature ability, Die For Me, can never be moved to another Persona. I believe the same goes for Lucifer's Morningstar, which I haven't found any other Persona that seems to be able to inherit it, not even Sat Denial. But disregarding these exceptions, the new fusion method of Gallows allows almost any ability to be transferred from one Persona directly to another. So before we talk about Gallows, we need to talk about skill inheritance in general first. There are several ways to get a desired skill on a Persona. The most obvious method is direct fusion. If the skill is inheritable, you simply need to find the persona with the requisite abilities, then figure out the correct fusion path to pass these abilities along to your target persona. However, using this method, you can only inherit up to 4 abilities total, so if you're looking to inherit more than 4 skills, you're going to have to use one of the other 2 methods for the remaining 4 slots. Additionally, sometimes there isn't a clear path to get an ability from one persona to another, or sometimes the fusion path is like really, really, in which case, you should consider the best method, if possible, which is execution. Execution is the easiest way to transfer a skill. You simply have to find the correct persona that gives you the correct skill card when executed. This works for a vast majority of abilities, and it's honestly the best method to take if it's an option. Plus, there's many sites online already that have full lists of itemizable skills. In this example here, I made an Ishtar with Dekaja, Dekunda, Marakunda, and Masakunda simply by sacrificing Fornius, Garamkala, Anzu, and Mokoi, and then feeding her the cards. This method also surpasses the 4 ability limitation of fusion, so if you're able to get everything you need from skill cards and fusion, there is no reason to use Gallows. Now, if the ability you desire is not skill cardable, and fusion isn't an option for various reasons, or if you simply don't want to sit around looking at charts and just want to directly transfer an ability, fusion becomes a great option. Take, for example, the Sat Denial I made of all the high-level elemental abilities. Is it fairly useless because he has no amp abilities? Sure, but it's still cool as hell. Or another example is my favorite persona here, Alice, that I've placed Victory Cry on. Now by the time I had gotten the Source persona for Victory Cry, I had pretty much already made Alice the way I wanted to, and I didn't really want to refuse her, so I used Gallows to transfer Victory Cry from Sat Denial. This is also the example I'll be using to show you how to target a specific ability using Gallows. So the way Gallows works is pretty straightforward. Simply choose one persona to sacrifice to another, and that persona will pass on experience as well as a random ability. Now, herein lies a trick. With the abilities that are transferable, the weighting doesn't appear to be equal. Rarer abilities appear to have a much lower chance of being passed on than the more common abilities. This observation may be completely anecdotal, but I've spent about 25 hours safe scrubbing with Gallows, and I really don't see anything that contradicts that observation. So I want to talk about how to get around the 2 major limitations of Gallows. I must mention, getting around these limitations does get expensive, so it's really helpful to have the discount from having a 100% compendium and a lot of money. The first limitation is that each persona can only receive 1 sacrifice per day, and this is actually really easy to get around. Simply register it, dismiss it, resummon it, and it's ready for a second sacrifice. The second limitation is that the ability is random, and the way to get around this is to narrow down the table of inheritable abilities by using reverse sacrificing. In essence, a persona will not inherit an ability that A, it can't inherit, or B, it already has. So what we simply do is sacrifice in reverse, overriding the source persona with a random ability from the target, thus creating a new uninheritable entry. We update it in the compendium, resummon the source, and then sacrifice the target back to the source. If the ability doesn't show up, we simply choose not to inherit, and then we resummon the newly updated source. And then we repeat the process as many times as necessary until you get the ability due to A, better odds, or B, because it's simply guaranteed. Now, of course, the downside of this is it completely screws the skill table of the source persona. But assuming you don't care about the source persona or you plan to refuse the source persona later, it really becomes an irrelevant point. So that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this Gallows Guide, and most of all, happy fusing.